Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lego Birds with another spring warbler warm-up video, and this one is going to cover black-throated green warbler. And this is a pretty common species during migration, and also a common nesting species in the Northeast. But in migration, you'll definitely see a lot of them in mixed warbler flocks. So it's a good one to learn well so that you can quickly identify them in mixed flocks and be able to move on to the next bird efficiently. Unfortunately, there's not really one defining characteristic that you're looking for to ID them, especially with the plumage variation. You'll have to rely on multiple field marks, but really the overall package is pretty distinctive, and you shouldn't have any trouble separating it from the other warblers once you learn it. Now, from the underside, you'll see a base color of white in the body, and then a variable amount of black in the throat, in the upper chest, and then kind of dark streaking down the sides. And some birds, especially in the fall, can show almost no black in the throat and a lot weaker dark streaking in the sides. And really that variation in black is the main plumage variation in this species. The rest of the field marks are pretty much consistent among all of the birds. And if we look at the back area, you can see it's kind of this greenish color, but that contrasts pretty distinctively with the brighter yellow face. And then the yellow face has kind of a darker patch in the cheeks, and sometimes the center of the cheek will look a little bit brighter again. And you can kind of see the same thing on this fall bird. You have the green and then the brighter yellow and then kind of the darker green again and then the yellow. So you have almost the concentric circles of light and dark. And you can also notice the really wide white wing bars. And there's not too many warblers that really have wide white wing bars like that, especially in combination with the other features. And you can see the wing bars from this angle as well. And like I said, this is one that is really worth learning well because you'll see it quite a bit. And it's really not too bad once you get the hang of it. So if you found this helpful, please like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.